Yellow Productions presents
10 things to know before you go to the city of Melbourne in Australia. I'm Chris. This is Topher. Together we make Yellow Productions. We do travel guides that are fun, informative, and entertaining. And if this is your first time here, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Click the bell to get notifications of all the fun new travel videos that we upload every week. But in this video, keep watching to know everything that you'll need to know to visit this city, Melbourne, in Australia. And we are standing on the banks of the Yarra River, the river that runs right through this town. The first thing you need to know about Melbourne is just a little bit of background on the city. It is the second largest city in Australia after Sydney. It is the capital of the Australian state of Victoria. It is often considered to be Australia's most European city. Actually, much of the city is foreign-born and has immigrated here. It has been voted the world's most livable city 7 years in a row. I haven't quite figured out where it is, but they mention it all the time here in Melbourne. Some words that people use to describe Melbourne include quirky, funky, eccentric, unique, and I might even use the word weird, not in a negative way, in kind of a cool way. You'll see there's a lot of street art and graffiti, and Melbourne, a little bit weird. When I'm a little bit weird, I like kind of weird places, so that's cool. Also in Melbourne, the city is often referred to as the CBD or the Central Business District. That's what you see behind me right there with all those buildings. And when they measure distances in Melbourne and they say, oh, this is X number of kilometers from the city, they measure that distance as a distance from the GPO, the General Post Office. Well, it used to be a post office, now it's an H&M. So if you go by the city, it's on Elizabeth and Burke. If you see it, you'll know that is the center of Melbourne. And by the way, if you're coming here, there's lots to do in the center of the Central Business District. You could probably spend 3 or 4 days touristing around just in the city center. You don't even have to go out to the outskirts. All right, the second thing to know about Melbourne is the weather here. And if you watch Game of Thrones, you'll know the phrase, winter is coming. It's coming to Melbourne. Actually, it's here. Winter here is like 9 months long. When I think of Australia, I generally think of warm and sunny. And if you can tell by the weather right now, it is not warm and sunny. I am not wearing my usual yellow t-shirt because it is quite cold. The lows since I've been here have been like 3 degrees Celsius or 40 degrees Fahrenheit. I mean, it's been chilly. In the summer, it can get quite hot. It can get 40 degrees Celsius, 100 degrees Fahrenheit. But the overnight lows, those same days, can be 18 degrees Celsius or, you know, down in the 50s or 60s in the Fahrenheit. So whenever you're coming to Melbourne, make sure to bring warm clothes. Bring a warm jacket, bring long pants. You're probably going to need it. It's situated on the bay, and the icy winds that come from, like, Antarctica or off the bay, they're just really cold here. So be prepared for cold weather anytime you come. And it can rain quite a bit, and the rain's pretty unpredictable. The few days I've been here, it has rained some portion of each of the days I've been here. So bring an umbrella, you will want it. And oh, by the way, if you live in the northern hemisphere, the seasons here are flipped from the northern hemisphere. So if it's summer in Europe, it is winter here in Australia. June, July, August, that's winter here. There's summer, December, January. So make sure you're thinking about that. The third thing to know before you come to Melbourne is about public transportation. Melbourne has the world's largest streetcar network. I don't know if you can see any behind me where I'm standing. They're running just over that way, but these streetcars, they call them trams. It's an extensive network that runs all over the city. They're pretty cool. There's some old ones, there's some new ones. I really enjoy traveling on them. You really don't need a car as a tourist in Melbourne. When you're riding the trams, you need to get like this little IC card if you're gonna ride them far away. If you're just riding them in the city center, they are free within the city center. And also there's this tram number 35. It's like a loop that goes around the city center. It's the tourist tram, and it even gives you kind of like an audio guide and tells you what you're looking at as you go around the city. So check that one out when you visit. In addition to trams, there are also trains. The trains use that same MyKey IC card. You can buy those IC cards at either the train stations, some of the tram stations, and you can also buy them from 7-Eleven. And you can buy them in like increments of a certain dollar amount. You can also buy like a week pass. So that's what I did. It was like 40 Australian dollars for a week's worth of unlimited travel. And so think about, are you going to travel a lot? If so, it might be worthwhile just to get the week travel pass. Now, the public transportation network is extensive, but it can be slow, particularly the streetcars. The streetcars run on the streets, and because they run on the streets, they're subject to traffic and stoplights and this and that, so it's not super quick to go across the city. There are plenty of taxis and plenty of Uber. They're plentiful. The taxis take credit cards. They're polite, so that's another great option as well. And the final great option in the city is feet. Melbourne is a very walkable city. And there's a train going behind me right now. There's a few major train stations in the city. I've taken the train a little bit, pretty good. Okay, the fourth thing to know, if you're coming to Melbourne, is about driving. So I know I just said you didn't need a car, but if you want to go outside of the city center, you want to go like the Great Ocean Road, you want to visit the 12 Apostles, you want to go see kangaroos and koalas in the wild, then you're going to need a car. And so if you're driving in Melbourne, there's a few things you're going to need to know. One, they drive on the left. Most of the world drives on the right. They drive on the left here. So just be aware of that. Also, they have a lot of traffic cameras. Melbourne and the state of Victoria is kind of a nanny state. They have 5 different types of traffic cameras, including traffic cameras that average your speed over long distances and will issue you a ticket if you're going too fast over a long distance. So don't drive too fast. Drive the limit. And if you're in the city center, you should also know they have this thing called a hook turn. So if you're at an intersection that has a tram, if you want to turn, I believe it's right, you actually have to turn right from the left. You go all the way over to the left, you wait in this little spot, you wait for the tram to go by, and then you make a hook turn. Actually, they show things how to do it on the State of Victoria website, so if you're coming here, make sure you understand what a hook turn is. All right, the fifth thing you need to know before coming to Melbourne is about the language. Chris, what do you mean the language? Don't they speak English in Australia? Well, they do speak English in Australia, but it's English, certainly a little bit of an accent. I haven't had a hard time understanding most people around here, but there was a waiter in a restaurant that I went to, and I couldn't understand a word that he said. So there's some slang words you should know. Slang? Maybe not even slang is the right word. They're just Australian English. So I call the things I eat with French fries that's red and made of tomatoes, I call that ketchup. They call it tomato sauce. When they use the word thongs, that means flip-flops or slippers, as you might call them in Hawaii. Those things, your sandals you wear on your feet with the little thong that goes between your toes. That's probably why they're called thongs. Like shorts for swimming, they will call togs, swimmers, or bathers. And finally, if you're driving and somebody says, hey, chuck a U-ey, that means to make a U-turn or to turn around. There's plenty more, but you'll pick it up as you come here. All right, the sixth thing to know before you come to Melbourne is about money. So in Australia, and in Melbourne, they use the Australian dollar. The Australian dollar exchange rate, when I did this video to US dollars, it was one Australian dollar is about 80 US cents. So one Australian dollar, 0.8 US dollar. The Australian currency, the size of the notes increases with the value. So as the value gets bigger, so does the size of the bill. The coins, the $1 and the $2, those are issued as coins. So don't throw away all your coins. They can be quite valuable. The lowest denomination of a coin is 5 cents. There are no pennies in Australia. Everything is rounded to the nearest 5 cents when it comes to a price. And the final two things to know about money, people always ask, Chris, where do you get your money from? Where do you exchange it from? There are some exchange places in the city, but get your money from an ATM. The ATM, you're gonna have the best exchange rate, and ATMs I've found in Melbourne to be plentiful. There's like an ATM pretty much on every single corner, and they take international cards. That's been pretty easy. The final thing to know about money is about tipping, and Australia does not really have tipping in their culture, so you do not need to tip. Occasionally you might see a tip jar, and tips are only for like super, super good service. They're not like some places where tips are just expected if people do things for you. So that taxi is not gonna expect a tip, it's just the price of the taxi ride is all you pay. All right, the seventh thing to know before you come to Melbourne is about store hours. And they close really early. This is something I've found very strange about being in Melbourne, is that at like 6 to 7, between 6 and 7, like, everything starts to close. I mean, there's tons of people walking around the street, but the stores close. So it's 7 p.m. is the closing time for most stores, though Thursday and Friday they're open later, often till 9 o'clock for some late night shopping. The exception to that rule is like restaurants, bars, drug stores, and supermarkets, they stay open later. But so if you want to do shopping, just make sure you're doing it before 7 p.m. Saturday through Wednesday. And the opening time for most stores is 10 a.m. Also, some restaurants or establishments, their hours will say something like open from 11 a.m. dash late. I had no idea what late meant, so I asked some local Melbourneers, and that's Ben, if you've seen my travel guide on Melbourne, and late means like 1-2 in the morning. So if you see late, you can expect places to be open until about that sort of time. All right, the eighth thing to know before you come to Melbourne is about food. Melbourne is a foodie city. The people who live here consider themselves really to be food connoisseurs. And so the food in Melbourne, it's pretty good. If you haven't, check out my video on Cheap Eats. You'll find a link in the description below. Cheap Eats in Melbourne, some of the places I ate at that I love and are cheap. Melbourne, I mentioned earlier, is a very international city, and so their cuisine is also very international. You'll be pretty hard-pressed to find Australian food. I mean, there will be some places that serve modern Australian, like kangaroo and meat pies and hamburgers with beetroot. But for the most part, they have a lot of Asian food, Italian food, kebabs, just a super international selection. Definitely visit Queen Victoria Market. They're only open in the day, like before, sometime before 2, sometime before 4 or 5. Lots of great food and eats at Queen Victoria Market. Some of my favorites here are Pepper Lunch and Tim Ho Wan. Again, though, more detail on those in my video on Cheap Eats in Australia. All right, and also if you're looking for supermarkets, the supermarkets here, Woolworths is a big one, and Coles is a second one. And we used to have Woolworths in the US, they've gone out of business, they were more department stores. Here it's a supermarket. And Coles is not the same one in the US, K-O-H-L-S, it is C-O-L-E-S, Coles. All right, I'm back, sorry for the strategic pause. I had to replace the battery on my microphone. Losing a bit of sunlight, I'm doing it in the sunset, so I'm gonna wrap it up. We got the last two to go. The ninth thing to know before you come to Melbourne is about coffee. Melburnians will tell you that their coffee is like some of the best in the world around here. And so when you're getting coffee here, it's mostly espresso-based drinks. And by the way, as a side note, I'm standing in front of the Melbourne Casino, and they have this like nighttime fire show. So if you see some reflections on my face, that comes from the fire on this fire show. All right, so the espresso-based drinks here, there's a few things they have here that you might not recognize if you go to a coffee shop. One, they have something called a flat white, which is a combination of espresso and steamed milk without the froth. They also have something called a long black, which is basically a double shot of espresso added to water. And the long black is the closest thing to standard American coffee. And they also have a short black, which is a standard espresso. All right, so let me wrap it up because it looks like I'm in a rave club or something. The 10th thing to know before you come to Melbourne is about water and beer. That's a really interesting combination, huh? It'll make sense as I talk about it. So if you search like water quality in Melbourne, you'll get to Melbourne City website where they will tell you that they have some of the highest quality drinking water. It's a loud motorcycle. Some of the highest quality drinking water in the world. And so how this relates to beer is people who live in Melbourne will tell you that Melbourne has some of the world's best beer because of the high quality water. So back to water and then on to beer. There's plenty of public drinking fountains across the city. They also have these bottle filling things. So pick up one plastic bottle, maybe even where you leave home, refill it as you go around the city, fill it in your hotel room. Tap water, super tasty, good for you. You won't get sick by drinking the tap water here. Also, back to beer now, because it makes the best beer. The legal drinking age in Melbourne is 18. They love their beer here. It is served everywhere with every meal, practically in every place. Well, not every place. Some places are called BYO, and then you can bring your own liquor. It's often typically wine, but you'll see it on the side. Some place might say beer and BYO, and that means you can bring your own drinks to that place. And if you're ordering beer here, it comes in two sizes, a pot or a pint. A pot or a pint. A pot is about a half pint. So those are some phrases you'll see. And if you're looking to try out some beer in Melbourne, you want to know the best place to do it, a really good iconic place, because it's also a place that's in my travel guide, the place I go first in Federation Square. There's a place called Beer Deluxe. They have a number of different Australian, Melburnian microbrews on tap. So you can check that out to sample some Australian beers. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoyed the sunset over Melbourne as the lights come on over the city, and I'm not too dark, but Topher's light because he's white. And Topher and I, we'd like to thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up below. If you didn't subscribe earlier and you're not yet a subscriber, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, hit the bell, or you might enjoy watching some of my other videos from Melbourne. Go ahead, click it, check it out, watch it, do it now. You know you want to. All right, bye-bye.